In the 1970 era, hula was revived, and my mother was very fortunate because a state foundation called Culture and the Arts that sent out letters to different hula dancers throughout the island. And my mother received one of these letters to come and study under Auntie Wakule Kuma'u. There, she learned how to hula with the idea that they were going to, these few dancers that met with Auntie Wakule, was going to go out to the community and teach hula. And that they did. As a young girl, I remember going to Kamehameha schools and McKinley High School and Lanaika Pono to watch my mother's performances. And of course, the highlight of the performances was watching Auntie Iolani Watine do her hula. So the dancers that studied under Auntie Wakule built a repertoire of hula. First, we learned Vika, Iwe, Hula Nobeo, Ayala Okale, and songs go on and on from there. So my mother taught it to me because being a child of a hula dancer or somewhat of a hula, it was important that the tradition carries on. And I'm very grateful for that because through all of this training, I am able to teach my children and the people of Las Vegas reap the benefits of that as well. I always pay a high respect to my mother because it was not easy raising children and traveling all over the island to perpetuate the culture. But we had to work just as hard as my mom, I think, because we had to go pick Makmare, we had to go pick Ilima, we went hiking up in the mountains, but it was all fun. We met people for myself, like Uncle Sam, like Ole, and he would sit and tell stories about them at hula, and it was just wonderful to be a part of it. So I always present this when I teach them. I tell them a story about how I watched my mother learn the hula, and then we learned it. And at first, we didn't get up and dance hula. We sat down and we had to learn the words, the mele. We had to know it, like the back of our hands. And then when we knew it, then we could get up and hula. Today, we do it a little backwards because we want them to be excited and keep it going. But sometimes I'm like, we're going to do it the way I was taught, exactly the way. So my mahine, my taiko mahine, are going to perform today doing a song called Hula no Veo. And the motions are exactly the way it was taught to my mama. And why I'm so excited to do this, not because we had a hula competition or anything, but these two young boys a couple of weeks ago, because you know when you have siblings and they're quite not dancing hula, but they gotta come anyway, because everybody gotta come to hula practice. So these two young boys, they sit down in class and they hear the chant over and over and over, and they say, Auntie, we can chant. So I called their bluff. I said, okay, they just up, let's go. And you know what? They will learn their words and everything, and not this song. What? I'm so proud.
Oh, DJ.
And I never forced them. When they come to me, that's the exciting part. So here we are. We're going to do our rendition of Hula no Veo. Oh,